April's astrology, and welcome to my backyard for my backyard report for the Grand Cross of April 2014. As you can see, nothing has grown yet here in New England. We have a lot of bare brown grass and a bare pot for plants. They have yet to bloom. But since the sun just moved into Taurus, it won't be long now before there's lots of green and leaves on the trees and people sneezing and allergies and beauty and the beauty of spring and new life. And so, here we are at the crossroads. Yeah. Place of the liminal place of the door between the worlds, place where those who have done bad deeds are buried. Well, I'm thinking of that more in terms of metaphorically in terms of shadow. Jung's idea of the shadow. We all have one. We all don't always think we do, but other people do. We're really good at pointing it out in others. Maybe not so good at seeing it ourselves. And the reason that is, of course, is because it's in shadow. Because that's what the shadow is. The shadow is the unconscious place in our own psyches where we can't see things. That's the point of having a shadow. And usually the reason things go there is maybe we've been shamed as children, or society has decided that the things, those things about us or our behaviors are not acceptable. Sexuality and death, mortality, aging, those things tend to be placed into shadow by society, by our families, and then we do it to ourselves personally. So we often don't feel connected in those ways, those sort of scorpionic ways. That's where the whole, that's life, that's the crux of life. Sex and death is, you know, that's the same thing as life. You want to have a life, you need to get connected. So this is what Saturn in Scorpio has been teaching us, scything away for like the last... Over a year now, yeah, more than a year now. I should know this. Whatever, I'll look at my ephemeris later. But scything away all the bullshit that we've had going on. Stuff that may not have been bullshit before, but now kind of is. It's old. It's done. And anything that is cutting us off from living a more erotic life. Erotic meaning life force. Not just meaning sex. Our culture is very adolescent and unsophisticated in how we view sexuality, you know. It's either hedonism or puritanism, you know. It's either repressed or over, you know, sensationalized. And so, coming into a more mature relationship with Eros, yeah? And with Thanatos, with death. So here we are at this crossroads. Yeah, place, a liminal place, place between the worlds, place that makes us very aware of mortality, as it is between the worlds. Place where we go to meet our shadow. And simultaneously, a place where we go to talk to the gods. Because we are presented with different paths. Four different paths right now that we can go down. Four different archetypal energies that are pulling us collectively in four different directions. From a very powerful place. This is happening in the four cardinal signs. Aries, where Uranus is, Cancer, where Jupiter is, Pluto is opposite there in Capricorn, and who am I leaving out? Mars, in Libra, going backwards, where he doesn't like to be. Mars does not like going backwards. But let's go through what these planets are and what they're doing to us. Okay? So Uranus is, he is the sky god. He is the god of heaven. And he is awakening. He's the awakener. So this is his archetype is, he shows up to say, this needs to be transformed. This needs to be innovated. This tower cannot stand anymore. It needs to go down. This is getting in the way of you expressing your genius. So I am going to hit it with a lightning bolt, and that's going to be the end of it. Okay. Because he says, I am your genius. And in Aries, he doesn't want to wait. He's going to do it now. And he's not a personal planet. He doesn't really care what our problem is. He doesn't care. He just is, these archetypal energies, as pure energies, they just do what they do. They don't care what our problem is. They don't care what security blanket we think we need. They do not care. They are merciless in this way. They are transpersonal energies. Yeah? Next is Jupiter. He is a social planet. So he's in between transpersonal and personal. Okay? And Jupiter is in Cancer, which is a very personal sign. Aries is, by the way, also. Cancer is a very personal sign. And he wants us to expand our idea of what home means. In fact, he wants us to understand that home is within. And we are always at home with ourselves. And that the divine is home. And any time that you take a breath in, and you take it out, and you are present with that breath, you have come home. You have awakened, and you have come home. He also is asking us on a more mundane level, what does home mean to you? Are you rooted? What do you need to feel expansive and happy? And what do you need to feel joy in your home life? Do you have that? Or is it just more utilitarian? Or do you have joy here? And then the next one is Mars. So let's get back to Mars. Mars is in Libra, retrograde. He is a personal planet. He's the masculine inside of all of us. He is the one who, he is the guy who motivates us to do anything. He's our ego. He's the part of us that fights for ourselves. But he's in Libra, so he wants to get along, which is kind of foreign for Mars. He doesn't really like that. He's feeling kind of impotent, too, because he's in Libra, he's going backwards. So he's not feeling all that, like, you know, he's not feeling like Mr. Man, necessarily. That's all right. He's also, Libra is the sign of Athena, who is the strategist. So this is a time for him to go backwards and strategize a little bit and think about his actions. And this, you know, connects with the crossroads in that at the crossroads, traditionally, those who have done deeds that were less than fantastic, that society didn't like a whole lot, were buried at the crossroads because they wanted those energies to be out of town and in those liminal spaces. So there's sort of a scapegoating energy there, too, actually. But getting back to the shadow, Mars as part of this, Mars going backwards into the past, where he's already been, as part of this Grand Cross, is also bringing us back to some of the things we've done. And having to encounter the karma of those things. What have we done? What have we done really well? What have we not done well? Have we harmed anyone? Have we harmed ourselves? And how do we want to interact with those shadows and shades? How do we want to put them to rest now? And hear their voices and let them tell us what they need to tell us so that we can move on. and move through this door into the next place. Yeah? So then, the last of these four planets that are crossing one another is, or squaring one another and in opposition, right? Down here, over here, and here, right? Opposite and square. And so the last of these planets is Pluto in Capricorn. He's in a transpersonal sign. He's in a societal sign. And he is the most merciless because he is deaf. Pluto is deaf. This is the guy who is bringing us in touch with our mortality and with death and rebirth, and it is time to let that which has already happened and has served its purpose, to let it go. He does not care that we don't want to. Doesn't matter. He says, anybody who was ever anybody in the world of mythology had to visit me in order to come back up with power. If until you're able to go into the underworld, you are a naive adolescent. Once you have died and been reborn, that is when you become a full adult, and that is when you come into your full power. Think like Persephone, queen of the underworld. She only became queen when she went down there and accepted the fact that that's where she was, and accepted her role as queen of shades. And she was no longer a maiden. Of course, that happens over and over again cyclically, but that's also the point of this. We were getting in touch with our mortality, yeah, and coming face to face with death in some ways, and then the fact of our own death, but also sexuality and rebirth. Again, coming back to that theme, Pluto in Capricorn, Saturn in Scorpio, that's a mutual reception. We are having to learn about the serpent energy. The constant shedding of skin, serpent energy having to do with hadith. This is the consciousness at the pinpoint consciousness at the center of the circle. This is the core, the very core of who we are, the core energy at the center of the star that we are. And so, if you think of this Grand Cross as a sort of a wheel, right, like the Wheel of Fortune, this serpent energy, these planets are all masculine. They're all masculine planets. So you think of this pinpoint of consciousness, the eternal self behind the thoughts. This is sort of the axle of the wheel that all of these planets are pointing to. Yeah? And getting us into that focus of who we are, that consciousness inside of ourselves, the core of the star inside of ourselves. Yeah, every man and every woman is a star. And so that star is your divinity. You are divine. And coming into consciousness of that is part of what this Grand Cross is. So it's really pushing us to stop identifying with external form. The things we have, the way we look, the people that we spend time with, our social circles, what they think, what our friends think, what our partners think. And purifying all of that and coming into who we just are, and working from that place, working from the place of will. Who are we? We're Alice in Wonderland having gone down a rabbit hole. Who are you? Right? Because everything seems very strange right now, because it feels, for some of us, like this has gotten taken away, and this has gotten taken away, and this has gotten taken away. Who are you? It's a trip! Because all the things we were relying on are no longer, they don't work the way they did. Even if everything looks the same, even if externally it all looks exactly the same as it did before, it's not. It's not the same. So now we're between two eclipses. We've got the lunar eclipse, that we just went through, the blood moon I talked about last week, and we've got the solar eclipse coming up in Taurus. Ah, Taurus shadow. So the shadow of Taurus brings us right back around to Scorpio. The solar eclipse will happen as a new moon, because they're always new moons, in Taurus. And so at 8 degrees, yeah? And the opposite sign of Taurus is Scorpio. So this brings us again into these mysteries of life and death, of manifestation and disintegration. Integration, disintegration. Birth, death, all of these kinds of things. We'll talk more about the eclipse next week. But we're between two eclipses with a grand cross. Again, this is like not just liminal space a little bit-ish. This is like uber liminal space. This is big time, like, this is your moment. If you want to change something, do it now. Don't stick with what you had. Do not do it. Okay? If you are in a situation that is dead, let it go. If you are doing anything that you are unhappy with, stop doing it. Okay? It may seem like you have to, but you don't. You have a choice. You always have a choice in this world. You make your own life. You have a choice. And there's karma to burn off. I mean, we're doing that too. So, I don't have the exact quote in front of me, but Jung was talking about this, and he was saying, you know, that freedom is doing gladly that which you must do, instead of thinking of yourself as a victim that has to do it, and woe is me, and I wish those people would stop making me, you know, have to have authority over myself and whatnot, and I wish they'd stop. You know, if you step into your own authority, you don't have to people can't do it for you. They can't have that kind of power. They only have it if you give it to them. But anyway, that's what it is. Stepping into the center of this grand cross, moving through this portal, talking to Papa Legba at the crossroads and asking him for his blessing as you move through this door. Asking for what you want, but not making a bad deal. Not letting your shadow self take over. There's many stories about that at the crossroads, too, where you meet the devil. Instead of the divine inside of yourself, you meet the adversary. And you perhaps give in to the illusion that there is some worldly thing that you need so badly that you're willing to give up your soulfulness for it. And that is the equivalent of staying with something that's not good for you. And that is the equivalent of going for things that you are externally identifying with that are not necessarily who you are. That's when it becomes a problem. You don't want that problem. This is your opportunity to let go of that problem. It's a lovely blue jay in that tree. This is your opportunity to not allow your shadow to run you, but to make peace with it, and embrace your own divine light, and to be, again and again, this comes down to the breath, and presence, and accepting yourself the way you are, and then allowing yourself to be guided from there. And so with that, I believe that I am complete with this report for today. Please do subscribe to me here on YouTube. My links are below from my website and my Facebook site, so please do go to my Facebook site and like, perhaps, if you do like what I'm saying and you want to be in the know of what's going on. Make sure you get set it so you get notifications. You can get a personal reading with me. This Grand Cross is affecting everyone very differently, so you can get a personal reading with me at aprilsastrology.com and enter into a drawing to win a free reading. Also, there on the contact page. Thank you for watching me today, and may you navigate this grand cross with grace, elegance, and much power, and many blessings.
Parin leg ba, kampe nan ba, yeah, yeah, yeah.